All right, my name is Robert Sayre. I'm from Mozilla Corporation. I'm a platform engineer there, and I also complained a lot about lack of unit tests and became in charge of a lot of them. So my slides are going to be all on a web page, so you can visit this later and follow the same links. Let's see here. Is that big enough? Can you read it?
Yep.
Okay. So the first thing is that unit tests are really, really important for our browser because we do security updates, and if we regress things in those updates, users aren't going to trust them, and they won't apply them, and our job will get a lot harder. And you know, competition's heating up in the space too, so we've got to make things faster, smaller, and better to stay in the game. And so the first thing is that the web is a wild place, and you know, the pages aren't made by professionals or anything like this. So we need to, you know, just kind of embrace whatever they throw at us and deal with it. And I think unit tests should be the same way. So what we do is we encourage contributors to write tests, and these people might not even consider themselves engineers. So this is just HTML and JavaScript. And we run them, thousands of them all the time after every check-in. So maybe it'll come up here. If it doesn't, I'm just going to stop it. There we go. So here's our tinderbox. This is continuous integration across Linux, Mac, and Windows. There are other things on other pages too, in Solaris and all weird stuff like that. So there's about, 40,000 every hour or so. And we pass most of them. We'll let things not pass and still run them just to make sure that we don't crash. Regression tests look something like this. They're just little JavaScript pages that run in an iframe. So it turned out that dependencies for running these were really bad, like having a web server around and things like that. So somebody decided to write a little HTTP server in JavaScript. It's actually really great because then people who only know JS can write server-side stuff, and we can run those. We accept donations of test suites. So we run things from Prototype, MochiKit, jQuery. And we'll, if you have big, complicated, nasty test suites for your app, we'll take those. We'll run them after every check-in. So how do we do this without, like, you know, WebDriver or Selenium or anything like that? What we do is we create a kind of a magic profile that lets localhost do anything. So it can log to files or write to the console. It suppresses, you know, slow script warnings, all that kind of stuff. And here's some other tools we have, just so that you can use them in your own projects. We have a thing called Dehydra, which is a C++ static analysis tool that's scriptable. So you can perform any kind of analysis you want using JavaScript on your code base. You have to know a fair bit about the C++ parse tree to do it, but it's pretty easy. It understands the preprocessor, so you can get around macros and things, which is pretty unique as far as I know. We have a JavaScript Buzzer, and what that does is combine JavaScript syntax productions in random ways and decompile them to see if, and then decompile them and then re-execute them to see that they're the same. That was just announced at Black Hat. We have some others that are coming that do more things that are more evil. I know that there are a lot of Java programmers here in the audience, so one tool that we've successfully used for Java stuff is called JQt. And what that is a it's a fuzzer kind of driven by static analysis so that it records test cases in a way that won't repeat, but it generates them kind of randomly. We have, one of our engineers wrote an incredible tool called Chronomancer, and that's a time traveling debugger that's built on Valgrind. And so that lets you replay exactly what happened and see the bug. It's amazing. We have JSON HTML output from Rational Purify, so you can run your unit tests under Purify and find memory safety problems. We have an instrumented copy of SpiderMonkey with dtrace support, so you can see the performance of your JS right down to the system calls. And there's plenty more on the Mozilla Wiki. That's it.
Thank you.